Hello, everybody. Ben from English World Center here. And today I'm going to be teaching you kids four using the active teach. So I will start by sharing my screen. I'm doing this because the teachers have this on our computers and it's what you have in your book. Here we have the page 72 and 73. So if you can go to page 72 and page 73 now, good. Okay, we are going to watch the video of the story. This story is called A High Temperature. A temperature is, for example, outside it is 20 degrees, it is 25 degrees, it is 23 degrees. It can also be the temperature of somebody. For example, if you feel sick, if you feel ill, you might have a temperature. Now, with the coronavirus, lots of people do have temperatures. I don't. Okay, I'm going to clear this and we are going to watch the video. Okay? Okay. Oh, not here. Here we go.
A high temperature? What happened, Ash?
I was playing football when suddenly...
Are you okay, Ash?
I don't feel very well. I feel dizzy.
You shouldn't play football when you're feeling dizzy.
You should go to the doctors.
I don't want to be ill. I'm going to London to watch the big football match this weekend.
Bo, you should stay with Ash and wait for his mum.
Do you feel dizzy now?
Not now, but I felt dizzy at school.
Have you got a runny nose?
No, I haven't.
Do you feel sick?
No. I don't.
Have you got a cough?
Yes, I have.
Oh, I should take your temperature. Let's see. Hold this under your tongue for 1 minute.
Excuse me.
You should be in hospital. Call an ambulance.
Ashok Gupta to Dr. Smith's office, please.
It's okay, Bo. My temperature isn't that high.
Don't worry, Ash. You'll be okay for your match at the weekend. Get some rest and drink plenty of water.
Thank you, Dr. Smith.
So, Ash, what was your temperature?
Did Ash have a high temperature? Okay, guys, so we've just watched the video, A High Temperature. Let me just close this bit. The video we just watched is from this. Okay, now what we are going to do is we are going to practice reading, repeating, and I am going to help with the words you don't understand. Let's start with number one. What happened, Ash? Repeat. What happened, Ash? I was playing football when suddenly I was playing football when suddenly. Suddenly means de repente. De repente. Okay, let's continue. Number two. Are you okay, Ash? Are you okay, Ash? I don't feel very well. I feel dizzy. I don't feel very well. I feel dizzy. If you feel dizzy, you are like, like, ooh. Okay. In Spanish, you say mareado. In English, dizzy. You shouldn't play football when you're feeling dizzy. You shouldn't play football when you're feeling dizzy. Shouldn't is talking about things you should or should not do. These are recommendations, recomendaciones, cosas que debes o no debes hacer. If you feel dizzy, you shouldn't play football. Oh, next one. You should go to the doctors. You should go to the doctors. You shouldn't play football, but you should go to the doctors. I don't want to be ill. I'm going to London to watch the big football match this weekend. I don't want to be ill. I'm going to London to watch the big football match this weekend. If you are ill, it is the same as being sick. Normally, we say to feel sick and to be ill. Okay? Football. Do you like football? I like football. I used to play football before. Antes jugaba fútbol. My favorite team is Chelsea. Chelsea, number one. Madrid, Barcelona, bad. Let's continue. And get rid of this. Yes. So right now I am using the rubber to clean the board or the screen. A screen is a pantalla. Screen. Bo, you should stay with Ash and wait for his mum. Bo, you should stay with Ash and wait for his mum. Again, you should stay. You shouldn't play football. You should go to the doctor and you should stay with Ash. To stay is stay there. Stay. It means to quedarse. Next, they are at the doctors. They are at the doctors. Bo is reading a book and asking questions. Do you feel dizzy now? Do you feel dizzy now? To feel dizzy. What is to feel dizzy? Very good. Next, he answers, not now, but I felt dizzy at school. Not now, but I felt dizzy at school. Felt is the verb feel. But in the past. So, before or yesterday or last week or last year, he felt dizzy. Now he doesn't feel dizzy. Have you got a runny nose? Have you got a runny nose? A runny nose is this. This is a nose. Okay. These are the eyebrows, the eyes. Yeah. The mouth. And normally, if you are unwell, you might have a runny nose. This is when your nose has bogies. In English, this is called bogies. Bogies. Mocos. A runny nose. Let's continue. No, I haven't. No, I haven't. Why does he say, no, I haven't? This is because the question, la pregunta, is, have you got? So you answer with have or haven't. For example, have you got dogs? Yes, you have. Or no, you haven't. Very good. Let's continue. Here, they are at the doctor's. Lots of people are feeling ill or sick. Bo asks, do you feel sick? Do you feel sick? The boy answers, no, I don't. No, I don't. He says this because the question is do. Do you feel sick? So his answer is no, I don't. Don't is the same as do not. Very good. Let's continue. Bo then asks, have you got a cough? Have you got a cough? If he does have a cough, what will he say? And if he doesn't? Very good. Yes, I have. He says he has a cough, or yes, I have a cough, because the question is, have you got? Very good, everybody. Let's continue. Now, Bo is going to take his temperature. I should take your temperature. Let's see. Hold this under your tongue for 1 minute. I should take your temperature. He shouldn't play football. He should go to the doctor's and he should take his temperature. Hold. To hold is mantener. Okay? Do you know where they are going to hold the thermometer? Do you know where? Under the tongue. Okay? What is a tongue? The tongue is this. Again, we have the eyes. We have the nose. We have the mouth. And if the mouth is open, we might see the tongue. This red bit is the tongue. Okay, very good. Under is, for example, under the table. If this is a table, and let's say that there is a book under the table, the book is here. Under the table. Very good, everybody. Let's continue. Now, Bo is worried. Bo está preocupado. Bo is worried. He has taken the temperature, and the temperature is very high. Very high. In this time, the woman is saying, "Excuse me," because she is coughing. What does Bo think? You should be in hospital. Call an ambulance. You should be in hospital. Call an ambulance. Ashok Gupta to Dr. Smith's office, please. Ashok Gupta to Dr. Smith's office, please. Bo is worried because the temperature is high. High. He thinks that the boy should be in hospital. In hospital. Then the doctor also takes his temperature. It's okay, Bo. My temperature isn't that high. My temperature isn't that high. High, alto. And if we say that something isn't that, plus an adjective, for example, English isn't that difficult. This means that inglés no es tan difícil. For homework, I want you to use this expression, no tan, in English, isn't that, for two sentences. Okay, another example could be Real Madrid aren't that good. Real Madrid no son tan buenos. Let's continue. Now the doctor is speaking to the boy's mum. He says, "Don't worry, Ash." The same as Bo before, but Bo was worrying. Bo se estaba preocupando. In this case, the doctor says, "Don't worry, no te preocupes." Just wanted to make sure that my microphone was working. You'll be okay for your match at the weekend. You'll be okay for your match at the weekend. Get some rest. and drink plenty of water. Plenty of means a lot of. Okay? This is lot, okay? Lot. A lot of. For example, a lot of people, a lot of homework, a lot of water. Mucho. Bastante. Okay? Next, the boy says, thank you, Dr. Smith. And Bo says, so, Ash, what was your temperature? So, Ash, what was your temperature? What was Ash's temperature? I'll give you some time to find out. Do you know? Very good. Let's see what it was. Ash's temperature was 37 degrees. 37 degrees. Degrees. Oh. Is in Spanish, grados. We use this to measure, to medir temperature. How do you say this word? Yes, temperature. Very good. Does he have a high temperature? In children, 37.9 and above. Above is the opposite of under or below. So if under is, above is good. Below or under, bajo or debajo, and above, encima or por encima. Very good. Here we have the word under. What was under? Very good. Let's continue. For the next activity, you are going to pause the video and you are going to choose the correct answer. In your book, you will have two options. Decide. At the weekend, Ash is going to London to watch the big football match or the big baseball match. Pause your video, do the activity, and then we will correct. The big football match. Very good. Let's see if it's the answer. We'll see the answer at the end, okay? Dad or Mum and Lois or Bo go with Ash to the doctor. Mum and Bo? Very good. Bo takes Ash's. This is Ash's. Bo takes Ash's runny nose. What is runny nose? So the correct answer is temperature. Very good. Bo is very worried. What is worried? Preocupado? Very good. So Bo is very worried. Because he thinks that Ash's temperature is very high. The doctor tells Ash to get some rest. Que descanse. And drink milk and juices. Drink plenty of water. Very good. Let's check our answers. Oh, this one I didn't choose. This is the correct answer. Okay, very good. In the next activity, you are supposed to do what we did before. So when I was reading the story, you were practicing. If you want, you can do it again. Okay? For the last activity, you are going to design, diseñar your perfect doctor's waiting room. What things are there? What do you want in a waiting room, in a sala de espera? Do you want to have a video console, some video games? Do you want to have a TV? Do you want to have, let me see if I can draw this. What is this? This is my favorite animal. It is a dog. I'm not the best drawer in the world. I do my best. There you go. This is a dog with his tail. Okay, I would definitely have dogs in a waiting room. What about a football? Would you have a football? Would you have a bed? Would you like to wait in a bed for the doctor? What do you think? This is homework. Design your favorite or your perfect waiting room and say, there is, for example, a TV. There are, because I would have a lot of dogs, there are a lot of dogs. Okay, everybody, this is the end of today's class, but we will be back soon with another. Thank you very much for listening. Thank you very much for being very, very good students, and I'll see you next time. Bye.